بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، وصلى الله وسلم على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدى محمد، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. وبعد، الحمد لله. Continuing the reading of the aspect number 96, 97 from Masail al-Jahiliyyah. Aspect number 97 from Masail al-Jahiliyyah, which was in regard to iftikharihim biintisabihim ila tayyibin ma'a mukhalafatihim lahum, which was that the people of Jahiliyyah, they used to be bragging about their lineage, meaning being, having some lineage with the tayyibin, meaning those who are the righteous ones, while being in opposition with them, meaning being in total opposition with those who are the righteous ones. So in this aspect, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala refuted them. As Shaykh Muhammad Ibn al-Wahhab, he say, فَرَدَّ اللَّهُ فَأَتَى اللَّهُ بِقَوْلِهِ, and Allah refuted them with this statement. تِلْكَ أُمَّةٌ قَدْ خَلَتْ لَهَا مَا كَسَبَتْ, this is a nation that had passed away, and they will receive what they have earned. In this mas'ala, the Shaykh Hafidhahullah, Shaykh Salih al-Fawdan, he explained that this was in regard to the Banu Israel, because the Banu Israel, يَفْتَخِرُونَ بِكَوْنِهِمْ ذُرِّيَةِ الْأَنْبِيَاءِ, that they were bragging about the fact that they were from the children of the prophets, عَلَيْهِمُ السَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ. But the whole thing is, دُونَ أَنْ يَتَّبِعُونَهُمْ, without following them, without following them. He say, وَلَا سِيَمَا إِنْ مُوسَوْ خَاتَمُ النَّبِيَّةِ Muhammad عَلَيْهِ السَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ. He say, إِنْ مُوسَوْ, being in opposition with the seal of the Prophet, the seal of the Prophets, عَلَيْهِمُ السَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَهَذَا رَدٌ أو فَهَذَا رَدَّ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ بِقَوْلِهِ, Allah refuted them. When he mentioned in Surah Al-Baqarah, verse 134, قال الله تلك أمة قد خلت, this is a nation that has passed, that passed away, لها ما كسبت, and that they will receive what they have earned. Shaykh Salih al-Fawdan, he expanded and saying that likewise those who الذين كالذين ينتسبون إلى أهل البيت, those who they ascribe themselves to belong to the family of the Messenger alayhi salatu wassalam. So they say they suffice themselves to the fact that they belong to the family of the Prophet. دون أن يقوموا هم بأعمال صالح, without them يعني performing righteous actions. So the fact that they think that they belong to the family of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, هذا يكفيهم, that this suffice them. وكذلك الذين يتوسلون بعمل النبي, and likewise those who are seeking nearness with Allah by the actions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, أو بجاه النبي, or by the might of the Messenger, or by the great the status of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And that's why you find some of the Muslims, when they make dua, they will always say بجاه محمد أو ببركة محمد وكل هذا لا يجوز. This, all of this is not permissible. To make dua, to say ببركة محمد, ببركة, بجاه محمد, بجاه فلان, all of this is not permissible to say. All of this are not permissible to do. طيب. But rather one He say, عملهم لهم, their actions are their actions. وعملك لك, and your actions are your actions. So likewise, on the hadith, and this is where we stopped last week, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he called the Quraysh. He said, يا معشر القريش, اشتروا أنفسكم. Oh, you people of Quraysh, ransom yourself or bail yourself out. Oh, you people of Quraysh. Meaning, اشتروا أنفسكم, بمعنى ransom yourself from the hellfire. Bail yourself out from the hellfire. And he mentioned, لا أغني عنكم من الله شيئا. That there is no good that I can bring to you, or no harm that I can repel from you. من الله, in front of Allah, شيئا, whatsoever. He said, يا عباس, O عباس, عم رسول الله. And Abbas was the uncle of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. Right? When the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم died, right? Who went to Abbas? In regard to what? أحسنت. بارك الله فيك آدم. What did he say? That's an important point right there. Al-istisqa. Alaykum as-salam. Al-istisqa. Very good. Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu anhu, after the death of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he went to Abbas. Who was the uncle of the Prophet alayhi salatu wa salam? He said, "Kunna natawassal bidu'a an-nabiy sallallahu alayhi wa sallam." We used to seek nearness with Allah by the du'a of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Meaning, we used to ask the Prophet to make du'a to Allah. We used to ask Allah to ask the Messenger to make du'a to Allah for the rain. So now when the Messenger died, Umar radiyallahu anhu, he went to Abbas and tell him the same thing. And he said, Anta, you are closer to us, meaning Aqrabun Nasab, closer to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, by what? By lineage. Qum, say, stand up and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the rain for us. Right? So here, he did not seek nearness with Allah by the virtue of Abbas on anything like this, but rather amara Abbas an yaqum wa yad'u Allah. He commanded Abbas to stand up and to make dua for all of them for the rain. So yep, this was this Abbas. He said, ya Abbas, am rasulillah, O Abbas, uncle of the Prophet alayhi salatu was salam. Ya Safiya, O Safiya, this was Safiya, the daughter of Safiya, the daughter of, she's the amma, the aunt of the Prophet, the daughter of Abdul Muttalib, yes, right, sister of Abbas, sister of Hamza, sister of Abdullah. Abu Talib, the son of Abdul Muttalib. Right, the uncle of the father of the Prophet. Yes, Abdullah. Yes, Abdullah ibn Abdul Muttalib. So this Safiya was the auntie of the Messenger alayhi salatu was salam. Afakala. Am. No, the khal, the am and the khal, they are different. The am is on the father's side. The khal is on the mother's side. You understand? The am is on your father's side. The khala is your mother's side. Right? The Arab, they make a difference. Your paternal uncle and your maternal uncle. In English, we say uncle. Or in English, they say uncle. Maybe some other, yani, some other cultures, they have different, you know, name when they say it, that mean right away, you know, the father side or the mother side. But the Arabs, they have it. The amma and the khala. طيب. So, ya Safiya, amma Rasulillah, the auntie of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or the paternal aunt of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He say, لا أغني عنكم من الله شيئا. There is no good that I can bring to you, or no harm that I can repel away from you, من الله, from Allah, يوم القيامة, in whatsoever case. He went to say, يا فاطمة بنت محمد. Oh Fatima, the daughter of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, the daughter of Muhammad. Salini min mali, ask me from my wealth. Ask me from my wealth. Ma shi'ti, whatever you wish. Right? La aghni anki min Allahi shay'a, that there is no benefit that I can bring to you yawm al-qiyamah in front of Allah. There is no harm that I can repel away from you in front of Allah yawm al-qiyamah. Shaykh Salih al-Fawzan hafidhahu Allah, he say, فالرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول لأقرب الناس إليه. The Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he talked to those who were the closest one to him. Right? He started with the Quraysh. And he called on to Abbas. Called on to Safiya. And then called on to Fatima. So he mentioned, لا أغني عنكم من الله شيئا. There is no good that I can bring unto you, or there is no harm that I can repel away from you in front of Allah يوم القيامة, in whatsoever case. فكونكم تنتسبون إلى الرسول. Shaykh Fawzan حفظه الله, he say now that the fact that you are ascribing yourself to be from the lineage of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, أو قرابة Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or to belong to the lineage or to the family of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, meaning you are his relatives. أو قرابة الأولياء, or being from the lineage, or being from the relatives of the أولياء, or from the صالحين. أو تتوسلون بجاههم, or seeking nearness with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by their status. هذا لا ينفعكم شيئا. This is not no benefit for you. No benefit for you. If that could have benefit, then Ibrahim's father wouldn't have been how far. If that could have benefit, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam uncle wouldn't have been how far. If that was a benefit, Lut alayhi salatu wasalam wife wouldn't have been how far. If that was a benefit, Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam son would not be in a fire. So now who are better than these, barakallahu fikum, that their own direct relatives, either father, either son, either cousin, either uncle, either this, either that, in the hellfire. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam father and mother in the hellfire. Prophet father and mother in the hellfire. If being, barakallahu fikum, the son, the father of a prophet would have benefit, do you think that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would not his father would not benefit from it? Do you think his mother would not benefit from it? Tell you. And هناك نقطه